elixir of life. It was Coleridge who said, "Water, water everywhere, but not a drop to drink," in his rhyme of the ancient manner. The recent verse of this could well read, "Water, water everywhere, but just a little that is clean." Owing to the colored, unsafe water prevalent today, Rotary District 3150 has taken steps to ensure clean drinking water to school students. The members of RI District 3150 have sought to harness water and thereby harness rewards for themselves. As put forth by the Sangam poet, their projects have won acclaim all over, and this has in fact motivated them to spread their wings and cater to the needs of the deserving with even more profundity. Providing handwells is, in other words, providing good and safe drinking water. Water, while being hailed as a life giver, has also faced a dearth, an acute scarcity in many different parts of the globe. In many places, the water is infected, polluted, and in reality, all sources of our drinking water, including municipal water, systems, wells, lakes, rivers, and even glaciers, contain some level of contamination. It's also a fact that even the chemicals which are so commonly used to treat water supplies, namely chlorine and fluoride, have undesirable effects on the human body. Researchers indicate that it is just 2 buckets, or in other words, 20 liters of safe water a day that a child requires to remain healthy. I am with the Rotarians of Inbadra Sarpaka and the company executives of the paper mills which you have visited. And of course, there are several press people here. We are right now inaugurating 20 handwells which Inbadra Sarpaka matched with your money. And you can see on the, I'll ask the cameraman later to pan the backside, and he will show you the environment in which these kind of handwells are being provided. And I have with me the president-elect, the president, of course, Raji is here.
Hi,
and past president Shankar. Hi. Babu, and several other Rotarians are here. We also have the JetPTC member, and a lot of Rotarians who worked hard to provide these 20 handwells. And on behalf of District 3150, I would like to thank you and all your donors. Thank you very much. For drinking and eating, washing, and also for basic sanitary purposes. Despite this, it is alarming to note that more than 10,000 children die every day just because they do not have access to an ample supply of hygiene, safe, quality drinking water. Many more children suffer from the undernourishment and parasitic illness caused by unsafe water and poor sanitation. With so many potential health hazards, the physical conditions of the population per se could well take a beating, more so when the fragile kids are in question. The dearth of clean drinking water does not just affect the physical well-being of children. In a country like India, children, particularly girls, are not able to attend schools regularly on time, as they are expected to fetch water for their families every morning, and most of the other children or discouraged to attend school due to the lack of separate and decent sanitation facilities in schools. And this includes unsafe drinking water as well. Basically, a country that thrives on the fertility of farms, India does not lack poor farmers and wage earners who became less productive due to waterborne diseases. This simply indicates the fact that without safe water and sanitation, sustainable development is impossible to any country. Taking these factors into account, the members of Rotary District 3150 decided to provide quality, safe drinking water to the school children.
Good afternoon, Jim. I am in a village called Gokulam, in a school in the village. This is a primary school where they have 38 children, and we have just dedicated a handwell. As you are aware, the big handwells were dedicated in the month of June itself, but we could not come and inaugurate all of them. Today we are inaugurating some of them, and tomorrow also I will inaugurate some of them. And I have with me all these children, and you could see them using the handwell. And they have a midday meal scheme, and at the back of my back of me is the school. And I would also want you to meet the master, the teacher, Mr. Reddy. So he has 38 children with them from class 1 to 5. And all these children study in the school at the back of me. And this is in a village called Gokulam.